This channel has been established for visually impaired people. For the visually impaired people, voice narration and a written expression are also provided for the hearing impaired. Don't forget to subscribe to our channel. There are a variety of pronunciations in modern English and in historical forms of the language for words spelt with the letter A. Most of these go back to the low vowel, the short O, of earlier Middle English, which later developed both long and short forms. The sound of the long vowel was altered in the Great Vowel Shift, but later a new long A or broad A developed, which was not subject to the shift. These processes have produced the three main pronunciations of A in present-day English. Those found in the words trap, face, and father. Separate developments have produced additional pronunciations in words like square, wash, talk, and comma. Contents 1. Overview 2. Old and Middle English 3. Further development of Middle English, A. 4. Changes in realization of, A. 5. Development of the new long A. 51. Before, R. 52. Before fricatives. 53. Before nasals. 6. Trap bath split. 61. British accent. 611. Trap bath split in received pronunciation. 612. Social attitudes. 62. Southern hemisphere accent. 63. North American accent. 7. Bad lad split. 8. A. Tensing. 81. Distinction between phonemic and non-phonemic. A. Tensing. 82. Phonemic. A. Tensing systems. 83. Non-phonemic. A. Tensing systems. 831. Universal. A. Tensing. 832. A. Tensing before per meter, and N. 8321. Additional, A. Tensing before, and 9. In foreign borrowings. 10. Other pronunciations. 11. See also. 12. Notes. 13. References. 14. External links. Overview. Late Middle English had two phonemes, A, and A, differing only in length. The A, short O, was found in words such as cat and trap, and also before, R, in words such as start. The A, long A, was found in words such as face, and before, R, in words such as scare. This long A was generally a result of Middle English open syllable lengthening. For a summary of the various developments in Old and Middle English that led to these vowels, see English historical vowel correspondences. As a result of the Great Vowel Shift, the long of face was raised, initially to and later to. After 1700 it was raised even further, and then diphthongized, leading to the modern standard pronunciation, E. Additionally, the short of trap was fronted to. This change became accepted in standard speech during the 17th century. Today there is much regional variation in the realization of this vowel. In RP there has been a recent trend for it to be lowered again to a fully open. These trends, allowed to operate unrestrictedly, would have left standard English without any vowels in the or area by the late 17th century. However, this putative gap was filled by the following special developments. In two environments, Middle English developed to rather than before non-prevocalic, R, e.g. in start, star, but not in carry, developed to in all words before some fricatives. Broadening happened inconsistently and sporadically. Words that had Middle English had a regular development to, for example, pa, however, before a nasal. Such words sometimes instead developed to, e.g. palm. The of the late 17th century has generally backed to in several varieties of contemporary English. For example, in received pronunciation the following table shows some developments of Middle English. A. In received pronunciation the word gate, which derived from Middle English, A, has also been included for comparison. Gate, cast, cart, cat, glad. Middle English Great Vowel Shift. Phase 1, Phase 2, Phase 3, Phase 4. Lengthening before, R, lengthening before, F, theta, S, fronting of, A, backing of, A, R, dropping. Bad lad split. Lowering of, A. The table below shows the results of these developments in some contemporary varieties of English, RP. Nay SCOIRL GA. Lengthening before, R, heavy check mark. Heavy check mark. Heavy check mark. Lengthening before, F, theta, S, heavy check mark. Fronting of, A, heavy check mark. Variable heavy check mark. Backing of, A, heavy check mark. Variable heavy check mark. R, dropping. Heavy check mark. Heavy check mark. Bad lad split. Heavy check mark. Lowering of, A, heavy check mark. Output for gate, cast, cart, cat, glad, gas. Old and Middle English. Further information. Phonological history of Old English and Middle English. Phonology. Old English OE had an open back vowel, written A, as well as a front vowel, A, written ash. These had corresponding long vowels, and ash, but were not normally distinguished from the short vowels in spelling. Although modern editions of Old English texts often mark them as an in the low vowel area, there was also a pair of short and long diphthongs, A, and ash, written A, the long one also A in modern editions. In Middle English ME, the short A, and A, became merged into a single vowel, A, written A in some cases before certain pairs of consonants. The corresponding long vowels also developed into this short, A, mostly, however, O, E, A, ash, and ash, were raised to become Middle English, the sound that often gives ea in modern spelling, and oe, was raised and rounded to become me, often o, oa in modern spelling. For more details, see English historical vowel correspondences during the Middle English period. Like other short vowels, the a was lengthened in open syllables later, with the gradual loss of unstressed endings. Many such syllables ceased to be open, but the vowel remained long. For example, the word name originally had two syllables, the first being open, so the a was lengthened. Later, the final vowel was dropped, leaving a closed syllable with a long vowel. As a result, there were now two phonemes, a and a, both written a, the long one being often indicated by a silent e after the following consonant, or, in some cases, by a pronounced vowel after the following consonant, as in naked and bacon. Further development of Middle English. Of further information, Great Vowel Shift and phonological history of English diphthongs. As a result of the Great Vowel Shift, the long a that resulted from Middle English open syllable lengthening was raised, initially to and later to, seems to have been the normal pronunciation in careful speech before 1650, and after 1650. After 1700 it was raised even further, and then diphthongized, leading to the modern standard pronunciation, e, found in words like name, face, bacon. However, some accents, in the north of England and in Scotland, for example, retain a monophthongal pronunciation of this vowel, while other accents have a variety of different diphthongs before historic, r, in words like square. The vowel has become often practically in modern RP, and in general American changes in realization of, a, independently of the development of the long vowel. The short a came to be fronted and raised to this change was mostly confined to vulgar or popular speech in the 16th century, but it gradually replaced the more conservative in the 17th century, and was generally accepted by careful speakers by about 1670. This vowel that of trap, cat, man, bad, etc. is now normally denoted as a in present-day RP. However, it has lowered to a fully front. Such a quality is also found in the accents of Northern England, Wales, Scotland, Ireland, and the Caribbean in North America. However, there is a trend towards tensing raising of this vowel. Raised pronunciations are also found in Southern Hemisphere English, and are also associated with Cockney for the possibility of phonemic length differentiation. See Bad Lad Split, below. Development of the new long A in modern English. A new phoneme, developed that did not exist in Middle English. The phoneme comes from three sources: the word father lengthening from A to A, for an unknown reason thus splitting from gather, the compensatory lengthening of the short A in words like calm, palm, psalm. When L was lost in this environment, and the lengthening of A before R in words like car, card, hard, part, etc. In most dialects that developed the Brada class, words containing it joined this new phoneme, as well the new phoneme also became common in onomatopoeic words like ba, ah, ha, ha, as well as in foreign borrowed words like spa, taco, llama, drama, piranha, Bahamas, pasta, bok, many of which vary between and a. Among different dialects of English, some of these developments are discussed in detail in the following sections. Before r, see also English language vowel changes before historic r. In late Middle English, pairs such as cat, cart, were pronounced, respectively, distinguished only by the presence or absence. Of however, by the late 17th century they were also distinguished by the quality and length of the vowel. In cat, the vowel had been fronted to cat, while in cart it had been lengthened to ka-rt. This latter change seems to have first occurred in the dialects of Southern England in the early 15th century, but did not affect standard English until the later 17th century. It has affected most varieties of contemporary English, which have distinct vowels in pairs such as cat, cart in non-rhotic accents. The r of cart has been lost. In modern RP the word is pronounced kt, distinguished from cat only by the quality and length of the vowel. This lengthening occurred when a was followed by non-pre-vocalic r. It did not generally apply before intervocalic r, when the r was followed by another vowel. Hence the first vowel of carrot and Mary has normally remained the same as that of cat, but see the Mary 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 merger. However, inflected forms and derivatives of words ending in historic r generally inherit the lengthened vowel, so words like barring and starry have, as do bar and star before fricatives. Unlike lengthening before non-prevocalic r, which applied universally in standard English, lengthening, or broadening, before fricatives was inconsistent and sporadic. This seems to have first occurred in the dialects of Southern England between about 1500 and 1650. It penetrated into standard English from these dialects around the mid-17th century. The primary environment which favored broadening was before preconsonantal or morpheme final voiceless fricatives, f, theta, s, the voiceless fricative, has never promoted broadening in standard English in words like ash and crash. There is, however, evidence that such broadening did occur in dialects. Once broadening affected a particular word, it tended to spread by analogy to its inflectional derivatives. For example, from pass there was also passing. This introduced broadening into the environment _sv, from which it was otherwise excluded. Compare passage, which is not an inflectional form, and was never affected by broadening in a phenomenon going back to Middle English. Alternate with their voiced equivalents. For example, late Middle English path alternated with paths. When broadening applied to words such as path, it naturally extended to these derivatives. Thus when broadened to, also broadened to. This introduced broadening into the environment before a voiced fricative. Broadening affected standard English extremely inconsistently. It seems to have been favored when a was adjacent to labial consonants or r. It is apparent that it occurred most commonly in short words, especially monosyllables, that were common and well established in English at the time broadening took place. See 1500 to 1650. Words of three or more syllables were hardly ever subject to broadening. Learned words, neologisms such as gas, first found in the late 17th century, and Latinate or Greek borrowings were rarely broadened. A particularly interesting case is that of the word father in late Middle English. This was generally pronounced, thus rhyming with gather. Broadening of father is notable both in two respects: its occurrence before an intervocalic voiced fricative, its distribution in many accents that do not otherwise have broadening, such as those of North America. The Oxford English Dictionary describes the broadening of father as anomalous. Dobson, however, sees broadening in father as due to the influence of the adjacent f and r combined. Rather and lather appear to have been subject to broadening later, and in fewer varieties of English. By analogy with father, the table below represents the results of broadening before fricatives in contemporary received pronunciation environment. RP, A, as in trap, flata, RP, as in palm or father, brado, underscore dollar, carafe, chifchaff, gaff, naff, riffraff, calf, chaff, giraffe, graph, telegraph, see above, half, laugh, staff, underscore C. Daphne, hermaphrodite, caftan, naphtha, aft, after, craft, daft, draft, draft, graft, laughter, raft, rafter, shaft, underscore dollar, hath, math, abbreviation for mathematics, bath, lath, path, underscore C, athlete, decathlon, pentathlon, biathlon, etc., maths, underscore dollar, alas, ass, donkey, ass, term of abuse, crass, gas, lass, mass, amount, mass, religious service, brass, class, glass, grass, pass, underscore asp, aspect, aspen, aspic, jelly, aspirant, aspirin, diaspora, exasperate, jasper, clasp, gasp, grasp, hasp, rasp, underscore aster, asteroid, astronaut, astronomical, etc., bastion, blastocyst, blastopore, etc., canasta, castanets, chastity, elastic, fantastic, gastric, gymnastic, hast, jocasta, mastic, masticate, mastiff, mastitis, mastoid, mastodon, masturbate, monastic, onomastic, pasta, pastel, plastic. Procrastinate, Rastafarian, raster, sarcastic, scholastic, spastic, aghast, avast, bastard, blast, cast, caster, fast, ghastly, last, mast, master, nasty, past, pasteurize, pastime, pastor, pastoral, pasture, plaster, repast, vast, underscore Alaska, basque, emasculate, gasket, Madagascar, mascot, masculine, masquerade, Nebraska, pascal, vascular, ask, basque, basket, cask, casket, flask, mask, mask, rascal, task, underscore blasphemy, underscore blather, fathom, gather, slather, father, lather, rather, other, see below, calve, castle, fasten, have. Raspberry indicates that the other pronunciation is also current in RP, indicates that this word had late Middle English, O, possibly in addition to late Middle English, A. Words in italics were first recorded by the Oxford English Dictionary later than 1650. In general, all these words, to the extent that they existed in Middle English, had a short a as in trap, which was broadened to. The exceptions are half and calf, which had been pronounced with in early Middle English before developing around the early 15th century to by L vocalization in accents of England. The development was subsequently the same as that in words such as palm. See below. The North American development to as in trap seems to be the result of shortening from hoff, cough, to, although there is little evidence of this development. Laugh, laughter, and draft, draft, which which all had in Middle English. This first change to accepted in Standard English from about 1625, but earlier in dialects, and was then shortened to the subsequent development was similar to other words with, such as staff. The development of draft. Draft is notable. In the 17th century it was usually spelled draft and pronounced to rhyme with caught, making clear its derivation from the verb to draw. The pronunciation with was rare, and its use in current English is a historical accident resulting, according to Dobson, from the establishment of the spelling variant draft. The words castle, fasten and raspberry are special cases where subsequent sound changes have altered the conditions initially responsible for lengthening in castle and fasten. The t was pronounced, according to a slight majority of 16th and 17th century sources in raspberry we find, s, rather than, z. The pattern of lengthening shown here for received pronunciation is generally found in southern England, the Caribbean, and the southern hemisphere parts of Australia, New Zealand and South Africa in North America, with the possible exception of older Boston accents. Broadening is found only in father. The success of broadening in this word alone in North America unexplained, and pasta, which follows the general pattern for recent Italian loanwords, cf. Mafia. In the Boston area there has historically been a tendency to copy RP lengthening, which perhaps reached its zenith in the 1930s but has since receded in the face of general North American norms. In Irish English, broadening is found only in father, which may, however, also have the face vowel in Scottish and Ulster English. The great majority of speakers have no distinction between trap and palm. The Sam-Som merger in Welsh English. Wells finds broadening generally only in father, with some variation in the north of England. Broadening is found only in father and usually half and master before nasals. There was a class of Middle English words in which o varied with a before a nasal. These are nearly all loanwords from French, in which uncertainty about how to realize the nasalization of the French vowel resulted in two varying pronunciations in English. One might compare the different ways in which modern French loanwords like envelope are pronounced in contemporary varieties of English words with Middle English, with the o diphthong generally developed to in early modern English, e.g. pa, daughter. However, in some of the words with the a tilde o alternation, especially short words in common use, the vowel instead developed into a long a in words like change and angel. This development preceded the Great Vowel Shift, and so the resulting long a followed the normal development to modern e. In other cases, however, the long A appeared later, and thus did not undergo the Great Vowel Shift, but instead merged with the long A that had developed before. R, and some fricatives as described above. Thus words like dance and example have come to be pronounced in modern RP, although mostly not in general American, with the vowel of start and bath. Words in this category may therefore have ended up with a variety of pronunciations in modern Standard English. A, where the shorter pronunciation survived, where the pronunciation with lengthened A was adopted, where the normal development of the O diphthong was followed, and E, where the A was lengthened before the Great Vowel Shift. The table below shows the pronunciation of many of these words, classified according to the lexical sets of John Wells: trap for A, bath for RP, versus general American A, palm for, thought for, face for E. It should be noted that while these words were often spelled with both A and O in Middle English, the current English spelling generally reflects the pronunciation, with O used only for those words which have. One common exception is ant environment. Trap lexical set, bath lexical set, palm lexical set, thought lexical set, face lexical set. Underscore dollar alms, bomb, com, palm, som, quam, sham. Underscore champion, rampant, stamp. Example, sample. Underscore amber chamber. Underscore pamphlet. Underscore ant, lantern, phantom, rant, scant. Advantage, ant, cant, chant, grant, plant, slant, vantage. Daunt, flaunt, gaunt, gauntlet, haunt, jaunt, saunter, taunt, vaunt. Underscore abandon, grand, random. Command, demand, Flanders, remand, reprimand, slander. Jaundice, laundry, Monday. Underscore franchise. Avalanche, blanch, branch, ranch, staunch, stanchion. Haunch, launch, paunch, staunch. Underscore evangelist, phalange. Angel, arrange, change, danger. Grange, mange, range, strange. Underscore bank, bench, financial institution, canker, flank, plank, rancor, sanctity. Underscore anger, angle, strangle. Underscore ancestor, finance, ransom, romance. Answer, chance, chancellor, dance, enhance, France, lance, lancet, prance, stance, trance, transfer, trans, lance. Ancient other. Salmon, almond. Not a French loanword in some cases, both the A and the O forms have survived into modern English. For example, from Sandra, a Norman French form of the name Alexander, the modern English surnames Sanders and Saunders are both derived. Trap bath split, trap bath split. An example of the trap bath split problems playing this file see media help. The trap bath split is a vowel split that occurs mainly in the southern and mainstream varieties of English in England, including received pronunciation, in the southern hemisphere accents of English, Australian English, New Zealand English, South African English, and also to a lesser extent in older Boston English, by which the early modern English phoneme, a, was lengthened in certain environments and ultimately merged with the long, of Father Wells 1982-100-1, 134, 232-33. Similar changes took place in words with O, see lot cloth split. In this context, the lengthened vowel in words such as bath, laugh, grass, chance in accents affected by the split is referred to as a brada. Also, in the UK, longophonetically, the vowel is in received pronunciation RP. In some other accents, including many Australian and all New Zealand accents, it is a fronter vowel or, and it may be a rounded in South African English in accents unaffected by the split. These words usually have the same vowel as words like cat, trap, man. The short or flat of the sound change originally occurred in southern England, and ultimately changed the sound of to in some words in which the former sound appeared before f, s, theta, ns, nt, ent, mpl, leading to rp for path and for sample, etc. The sound change did not occur before other consonants, thus accents affected by the split preserve a in words like cat. See the variations section below for more details on the words affected. The lengthening of the bath vowel began in the 17th century but was stigmatized as a cockneyism until well into the 19th century. British accents. The presence or absence of this split is one of the most noticeable differences between different accents of English. English and isogloss runs across the Midlands from the Wash to the Welsh border, passing to the south of the cities of Birmingham and Leicester north of the isogloss. The vowel in most of the affected words is usually the same shorta as in cat. South of the isogloss, the vowel in the affected words is generally long. Gupta 2005. There is some variation close to the isogloss, for example in the dialect of Birmingham, the so-called Rummy. Most of the affected words have a short a, but ant and laugh usually have long vowels. Additionally, some words which have a in most forms of American English, including half, calf, rather and can't, are usually found with long vowels in the Midlands and Northern England. In Northern English dialects, the short a is phonetically, while the broad a varies from two. For some speakers, the two vowels may be identical in quality, differing only in length versus Wells 1982-356, 360. John Wells has claimed that Northerners who have high social status may have a trap bath split. Wells 1982-134 and has posted on his blog that he grew up with the split in Upholland, Lancashire. A.F. Gupta's study of students at the University of Leeds found that on splitting the country in two halves, 93% of Northerners used in the word bath and 96% of Southerners used. However, there are areas of the Midlands where the two variants co-exist, and, once these are excluded, there were very few individuals in the North who had a trap bath split or in the South who did not have the split. Gupta wrote, "There is no justification for the claims by Wells and Mugglestone that this is a sociolinguistic variable in the North, though it is a sociolinguistic variable on the areas on the border. In some West Country accents of English, English where the vowel in trap is realized as rather than, the vowel in the bath words was lengthened to and did not merge with the, of father. In those accents, trap, bath and father all have distinct vowels, a, and, Wells 1982-346-47. In some other West Country accents, and in many forms of Scottish English, there is no distinction corresponding to the RP distinction between, a, and, trap, bath split in received pronunciation. In received pronunciation RP, the trap bath split did not happen in all eligible words. It is hard to find a clear reason why some changed and others did not. Roughly, the more common a word, the more likely that the change from flat A to broad took place. It also looks as if monosyllables were more likely to change than polysyllables. The change very rarely took place in open syllables, except where closely derived from another word with, thus passing is closely derived from pass, and so has broad A. P.S. passage is not so closely derived, and thus has flat a, pised. Here is the set of words that underwent transition, and counterexamples with the same environment. feet, aft, after, craft, daft, draft, draft, graft, haft, laughter, raft, rafter, shaft, caftan, taft, word final, theta, bath, lath, path, hath, maths, polymath, word final, s, brass, class, glass, grass, pass, ass, donkey, bass, fish, crass, gas, lass, mass, amount, morass, sass, sk, ask, bask, basket, cask, casket, flask, mask, mask, rascal, task, asquith, gasket, mascot, word final, sp, class, gasp, gasp, grasp, hasp, rasp, asp. Word final, street, aghast, avast, blast, cast, cast, contrast, fast, last, mast, past, repast, vast, bast, iconoclast, paderast, hast, miscellaneous, street, bastard, caster, caster, disaster, ghastly, master, nasty, pasteurize, pastime, pastor, pastoral, pasture, plaster, aston, astronaut, castigate, chastity, drastic, pasta, pastel, plastic, raster, mustache. All other words in this set, word final, v, calv, have, sav. Note, only when spelled alv, chav, have, ample, example, sample. Ample, trample, nd, Alexander, Alexandra, Sandra, Chandler, command, demand, Flanders, remand, reprimand, slander. All other words in this set, nt, advantage, ant, can't, chant, grant, grant, plant, shant, slant, ant, banter, can't, fantasy, mantle, phantom, rant, scant. Word final, ent. All words in this set, branch, planch, ranch, etc., ns, advance, answer, chance, chancellor, dance, enhance, France, glance, lance, lancet, prance, stance, trance, anson, cancer, fancy, ransom, romance, castle, fasten, raspberry. For the words in the last row, subsequent sound changes have altered the conditions initially responsible for lengthening. There are some words in which both pronunciations are heard among southern speakers, the words basque, bastard, chaff, Glasgow, lather, mass, church service. Greek elements as in telegraph, blastocyst, chloroplast. Words with the prefix trans, use of brada in mass is distinctly conservative and rare now. Other international fluctuations are both common, but with further complications. While graph, telegraph, photograph can have either now in received pronunciation, they have broad A, graphic and permutations always has a flat A, broad A fluctuation. In dialects that include it, before S it is a more common alternative when in its common voiceless variant, S, rather than Z, in transfer, transport and variants than when it is voiced. Thus translate, transatlantic social attitudes. Some research has concluded that many people in the north of England have a dislike of the vowel in Bath words. A.F. Gupta wrote, many of the northerners were noticeably hostile to R.S., describing it as comical, snobbish, pompous, or even for morons, whilst writing on a Lobovian study of speech in West York. K.M. Pettit wrote in 1985 that several respondents positively said that they did not prefer the long vowel form, or that they really detested it, or even that it was incorrect. However, Joan Beale said in a 1989 review of Pettit's work that those who disliked the pronunciation still associated it with the BBC and with the sort of professional jobs that they would aspire to. Southern Hemisphere accents. Evidence for the date of the shift comes from the Southern Hemisphere accents, those of Australia, New Zealand, and South Africa. In Australian English, there is generally agreement with Southern British in words like path, laugh, class, but before N consonant, as in dance, plant. Most Australians use a flat A, ant and can't, however, are invariably pronounced with a broad A phonetically. The broad A is in Australia. There is variation in the word castle. Both pronunciations are commonly heard. For more information, see the table at variation in Australian English. In South Australian English, the broad A is usually used. South African and New Zealand English have a distribution of sounds similar to that of RP. North American accents. Most accents of American English and Canadian English are unaffected by the split. The main exceptions are parts of New England. See Boston accent, where the broad sound can be used in some of the same words as in Southern England, such as ant, ask, bath, etc. Ant, though, is unique, as the broad A pronunciation is found sporadically throughout the U.S., not only in New England-related, but distinct, phenomena include the following: the phonemic tensing of A, in the accents of New York and particularly Philadelphia, in which tensing occurs specifically before in New York. Tensing occurs in more environments, see section below. The drawled pronunciation, A, in Southern accents, many South Midland, Appalachian English, and inland Southern speakers also raise the A, in ant, dance, plant to or bad lad. Split the bad lad ad split is a phonemic split of the early modern English short vowel phoneme a into a short a and a long ash. This split is found in some varieties of English English and Australian English in which bad with long and lad with short do not rhyme. Wells 1982-288-89, 596, Horvath and Horvath 2001, Leitner 2004. The phoneme a is usually lengthened to ash when it comes before an per meter or n within the same syllable. It is furthermore lengthened in the adjectives bad, glad and mad. Family also sometimes has a long vowel, regardless of whether it is pronounced as two or three syllables. Some speakers and regional varieties also use ash before l and or d. Such lengthening may be more irregular than others. Lengthening is prohibited in the past tense of irregular verbs and function words and in modern contractions of polysyllabic words where the a was before a consonant followed by a vowel. Lengthening is not stopped by the addition of word-level suffixes. British dialects with the bad-lad split have instead broad, in some words wherein per meter, or n, follows the vowel. In this circumstance, Australian speakers usually but not universally use ash, except in the words ant, cant and shant, which have broad, a. Daniel Jones noted for RP that some speakers had a phonemic contrast between a long and a short a, which he wrote as ash and a, respectively. Thus, in an outline of English Phonetics 1962, 9th edition, Cambridge, W. Heffer. Speakers as band, b ash nd, and band, band. Australian speakers who use span as the past tense of spin also have a minimal pair between longer, sp ash n, meaning width, or the transitive verb with a river or divide, and span, the past tense of spin, span. Other minimal pairs found in Australian English include manning, the surname, main, and manning, the present participle and gerund of the verb to man, m ash n, as well as planet, plant, versus planet, place ash ent. Apart from Jones's, dictionaries rarely show a difference between these varieties of a tensing in the sociolinguistics of English. A tensing is a process that occurs in many accents of American English, and to some degree in Canadian English, by which a it appears before nasal consonants. Thus, for example, in fan as opposed to fat, a tensing in North American English environment. Example words: dialect consonant after a syllable type. Canadian, Northwestern, Upper Midwestern USA, Cincinnati, traditional Delaware Valley, Eastern New England, General USA. Open. All other consonants. The lax vowel. General U.S. calf, e.g. the calf was born today. CAF, e.g. students must eat in the CAF versus both, typically.